And what we can see here, if we look at this, is this alcove used to be a flat wall that ran along here. So it was turned into this kind of vestibule alcove to allow more natural light to come in from the sides. Because as you can see from this photo, it's quite a dark space and it even still feels dark today. And it's a very special wallpaper, a Japanese technique called kinkarakami. And it's this seven-layered process of putting mulberry wood on. What had happened is it kind of had oxidized and gone brown. And so what you'll see here, these brown parts, picture all of the floor was just covered in brown by the time Louisa moved in. So what she did was a bit shocking to some, but in the 1930s she came through with cream paint and painted over everything. So we can see the brown creeping through again now because it's only 100 years since she did that. But originally she just went through and did everything, including the black Spanish marble columns. So we can see from the photo that this is what they should look like. But they're actually cream now. We can move into the drawing room now. This is where Louisa would host all of her important guests. Some work done in this room because it's all cream, including the piano, which was a mahogany piano of dark wood, and it's now cream. When I mentioned before that the house ended sort of here, this is the bit that was added on. Originally it was an office with the fireplace in the centre of the room, and then it was added to become that drawing room. We just gotta stay. We can go out to the conservatory. This is one of my favorite spaces. It's really special because it shows just what they were capable of doing in the Victorian era with techniques that came from the Industrial Revolution, like steel and glass manufacturing. And it's also special because the first owner and the third owner really loved exotic plants like orchids and ferns. So he had this space to be able to show his guests his wealth, for one, but also because people would have never been able to see plants like this in a Melbourne climate. When it gets too hot, that vent can be opened with the lever. So it would be able to control the temperature of the plants. Very special. Can I have a closer look at it? Because it's very, very ornate, and the carving is just incredible. There's always different things layering here as well. I love the influence. We'll head this way now. We'll just have a little stop and have a look at this, which I'm sure everybody knows what this is. It's a little servant's bell. So that bell connects to a board in the kitchens to show you which room the family member would be in. So when they want their gin and tonic or anything, they would just be called by the bell. And we'll walk down through the servants' hall and just have a look at how different it is compared to the ornate detail here and the very pared back nature of this hallway. Thank you. show you, this is now the commercial kitchen, but what you can actually see is the board that I mentioned that would notify the service. But we'll just stay through here. And what you can see from this side in the servants' hall is that it's not painted cream. So it didn't get the cream paint because the servants didn't need it. Do you want to move through now to that? Take a look back at the door now. You can actually see the stained glass pattern a lot better. This painting is titled Glory, but Louise's children really didn't like it. They actually called it Misery because it was the first thing they saw every day when they'd have to come down the stairs. This, for example, is another sort of thing. These are some family portraits on the piano as well. That is special. Family portraits here is Louisa in the middle on her wedding day, 1921. This room is really special because it is one of the only rooms in the house that remains intact with all its furniture, because when Louisa passed away and the house became the property of the National Trust, they decided to purchase every bit so that it remained in the house. And Louisa had picked all this furniture and the dining setting to match the carpet, which is the original carpet from the 1880s. And she tied in all the colours of the orange and the blues, as you can see with the curtains as well. Those curtains are real Venetian silk, so very, very delicate material, and that's why we actually have to keep them closed to protect them from the light outside. If you were to see out those two curtains though, they're actually French doors that lead to the ballroom. So there was this flow-on effect from the entertainment. And also, it adds to the sense of drama having the recessed lighting in the top that kind of looks like a Hollywood movie theatre from the 1930s. And in the back corner over there, you can see two brown wooden doors that are servery windows into the kitchens. The plate settings as well, they actually came from Meyer and Rock, which was the original Meyer store. And they were designed especially for Louisa. With that orange and blue again, tying into the theme of the carpet. This room now that we're going to enter into is styled for more the 1950s, and you'll notice probably by the orange shag pile carpet. And it's had many different uses, from a library to a breakfast room to in Louisa's later life it was the room she spent a lot of her time in. You'll notice that there's some dog baskets in here because she really loved her dogs, and even one of the slides on the projector at the moment has a photo of two of her dogs. Three of her dogs, sorry. The property became passed to the National Trust in 1973. And that was where, after a long legal battle, that Louisa had fought to protect it against the government trying to acquire the land that was at the lake. They wanted to put some more broadcasting studios, ABC broadcasting studios. They wanted to expand, and if they had done that, it would have destroyed the lake. So she fought it in courts for 10 years, and the only way to sort of get around that was by passing the property to the National Trust upon her death. But we're very lucky she did that, because it means that we have Rippon Lea in the condition that it is in. And on the TV screen at the moment, you'll see a birthday party happening. That was Wanda's birthday party, and she was the friend of one of the daughters. So that was in the ballroom when she turned 21. We'll now head upstairs. So the stained glass actually tells a story. In the first panel it says morning, in the middle it's noon, and in the final panel it's night. So you've got the rising sun, the blooming flowers, and then the crescent moon and the owl in the final panel. We'll come now into the best bedroom, which is really just the master room. But on all the plans, since it was May, it was called the best bedroom. I do think it has one of the nicest views out to the west lawn. windows, you can also see down to the pool, which is where Louisa had a lot of her pool parties. This is an original piece of furniture, and it was actually a wedding gift, and it was a symbol of their love that would last forever. In each panel, there are birds that mate for life. And if you get really close, you can see that it's hand embroidered. This was her dressing room. These dresses are not hers, but they are of the time. And in the cupboard, the furs and dresses are her original clothes. We'll head now into her bathroom. So it has all still the original Victorian era fittings, the bathtub, one of the earliest flushing toilets in Melbourne, and the tile work. They're really interested in innovation, so they even have a really cool idea, which is a shampoo tap. So it would have a tube attached to it that would dispense shampoo. Just watch the steps. Even on a cloudy day, you can see right out to the city. This is a painting of Louisa, and it was painted in 1969, so only a few years before she passed away. But it really shows the kind of person she was, just a bit of a spark to her, a very glamorous woman. And the room we're about to go in was actually her husband's room, so they had their own bedrooms. This here is a picture of Winnie Sargood, so one of the daughters of the first owner. And this could have been her room at one stage. Right now it's styled for a daughter during the Victorian era, so we can sort of see what they would have had. And over on that nightstand there is a picture of Frederick Sargood, the first owner. These two rooms are connected. They're for the night nurse and the night nursery. So for the children in here, and the servant that looked after them was in this room. And there's adjoining room, if you'd like to come in. A room that connects them so that she could always get to the kids if they needed. You'll notice in here this room is much more pared back to the other bedrooms, especially that it's got no carpet and no heat source, no fireplace. Very different life for the sevens, but to be included on this console was a big status as well, because all the other sevens were in the Louisa used to have her parties, and she would get her jewels that would come from the bank. And at the end of the night, rather than putting in the safe that was in her wardrobe, she had a cheeky little safe in the top of the door just there. So there's a cavity about that big. You could probably, you're tall enough to actually reach in it. Just in the top, on the top of the door. Yeah, a bit further in. Yeah, there's a gap. So that's where she store the jewels, sorry. Oh yeah, you could probably. And that way, in the morning, the chauffeur would come back, collect the jewels, and take them back to the bank. Yeah, it's a very heavy door as well. And we kind of don't go down that way, but it's all of the servants' quarters that are now office spaces and rooms for the employees. last two rooms were connected to the waiting room, and they were the gentleman's washroom and the cloakroom. But the cloakroom is now an office space. This being the gentleman's washroom, women were actually not allowed in here, it was just for the men. And just to really hit that home, the toilet seat is actually on a spring, so it will always be in the upright position. Thank you.